Ma'am, I have a question. As a lay person, I just want to understand, that is one. The other is that if the doctor, if there are no injury marks, so it is not sure whether the victim consented or not consented. It can even go against the victim, that she may have consented. But that is up to the judge to appreciate the evidence and then conclude. But the other thing that comes in the report, as far as my limited knowledge goes, is about the finger test, whether one finger, two finger, yes, no. If that is not taken as evidence in court, then what else can be taken?
No, so at the case sheet, whatever protocol is there, it contains other than identity, history of a patient in detail. About history, pre-assault history, assault history and post-assault history. And then mentioning the injuries in detail, whatever we find it. But these are the findings which only can be proved. We cannot do more than this as far as doctors are concerned. So and in case there are injuries and there are external injuries and as well as patient's history also goes accordingly, we can say okay, there was an evidence about the rape, aggressor can be. But in the absence of injuries, we definitely cannot comment anything. But it depends all on the history. Because we cannot, we cannot make out anything when there are no evidence.
So in the absence of any injury marks or in the absence of such, you are saying that a doctor's evidence is not conclusive proof as to whether they passed
away. That's why we cannot give them opinions at that time.
Okay.
इंफेक्शन हिस्ट्री जानने का क्या महत्व?
ये बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. दिस हिस्ट्री, सेक्सुअल हिस्ट्री हम बिल्कुल वही पूछते हैं जो कि इस केस के लिए जरूरत हमें महसूस हो. और जिस हिस्ट्री की हमें इस केस के साथ अटैच नहीं है वो हम नहीं देते. लाइक अगर सेक्सुअल हिस्ट्री एक हफ्ते के अंदर अगर उसकी किसी से सेक्सुअल तो वी विल रिकॉर्ड इट. बट अगर वो मैरिड है, शी हैज सम बॉयफ्रेंड और उसके साथ उसका अफेयर है, दैट इज नन ऑफ आवर बिजनेस.
उससे फर्क क्या पड़ता है? अगर मान लीजिए
एक वीक के अंदर
और आज मेरा रेप हो
जाता है, क्योंकि जब हम स्पर्म्स करेंगे, जब हम उसका स्पर्म्स देखेंगे तो हम डीएनए एनालिसिस करेंगे, हम हमें बताएंगे कि किसके साथ हुआ था. तो अगर डीएनए एनालिसिस उसके साथ मिलता है तो दैट इज दैट वाज अ कंसेंसुअल एक्ट. बट अगर डीएनए उनके साथ नहीं मिलता तो इसके साथ होगा. सो दैट इज जस्ट टू हेल्प अ विक्टिम.
ओके, द लास्ट क्वेश्चन वी
टेंशन ऑफ पुलिस एंड देन दिस वन जुडिशियल. But I equally feel that sensitization of doctors is equally important, because Dr. Meera Shiva, I remember all in all the Meera says that in a medical institution, when imparting a medical education, never been taught about the gender justice, how to deal with the villain patient. Yes. And I'll give you in my example, forget about the thing in second, if one patient, one doctor who's taking care of the other doctor refused to examine this is your patient, you know, that level of insensitivity. And forget about the rape or going through the process, because then we get to hear number of times the hospital doctors, including all the paramedical staff, are not being sensitive. I think this is just in now medical institute of education, so they have to also have a kind of a course with sensitization of the gender. And like you said, judge need not take a two norms, a two finger test, because what happened again, the person, doctors who are going as an expert has to train also what is the problem, because the defending counsel will definitely ask those questions in order to win the case. So therefore, you are also the duty cast of all, if they are trained. They say these are not necessary, this cannot be asserted, then automatically in the argument that judge will discard those as an evidence. So
there is definitely a training. NGO organizations say here, we have had few sensitization workshops also. This was regarding not only for this clinical examination, this was for the sensitizing our paramedical staff also.
Yes, yes.
Our nurses were also sensitized. So that was these workshops do there.
And you know that not only the sensitization, the post-trauma counseling, not only for the
education,
for the doctors should be there after this Jyoti's case, how much trauma that even the doctors have gone through. I will say whole of the country has gone through. It's not
in the education.
Thank you. Thank you. You can continue your discussion later. I just want to say two things. Counseling training is tarah se diya ja sakta hai medical staff, medical personnel ko. That's an important issue we haven't even touched. Secondly, I'm trying to remember the website. There are four manuals which are up on the, as far as I remember, it's the DMR website. I may have got the thing wrong. Please search for it. Four manuals are up on the, this is the medical, if I'm not mistaken, it's medical research, the Department of Medical Research. Look under Ministry of
Health.
Under Ministry of Health. Ministry of Health has put up four manuals and they're looking for people to give their comments on their manuals before their draft manuals. So, वो actually टिप्पणियाँ चाहते हैं लोगों से. Please जाके search करिए उन manuals को निकलवाइए या guidelines.
Yeah, the guidelines they are still not, they have not come up. But
no, it's in a draft form. So some of us have already given in our comments. Please give your comments to the four manuals which are up on their website. उन्होंने डाल रखा है, उन्होंने उसको publicize नहीं किया है, तो बहुत लोगों को पता नहीं है इसके बारे में. Please go check the website. It's on the Health Ministry website. And it's a good way to engage with these issues of character of woman's history, her character, वगैरह वगैरह, counselling, ये सारी चीजें, ये सारी बातें जो हैं, आप वहाँ पे जाके आप अपने टिप्पणियाँ जो हैं, अपने सुझाव दे सकते हैं. So thank you to the panel. Thank you very much.
After lunch, we'll continue with the next session, which is identifying issues and concerns for psychologists. Thank you. Of the middle class
not apart themselves, then there is another male boundary. Young or hanging around, and they will get sex work there, and all of them will share that in women. So it's another male boundary, but there is no excessive violence, but implicit violence. In this daily. And it is the constant carrier in India, Congo, where women, the shot, the soft target are exposed to rape and rage. The Indian army has raped a whole village. The women, both single and married. So much so that these girls and women were ostracized by their own people. Only one by the black and women were the women and children of the village. And the married women were also not accepted by their own family. What happens to them? They live with this stigma of their lives, and their lives, both the physical, mental, emotional, working with them, last year, and was still suffering from the trauma. I was there to bring up their wounds, but to just healing. And my whole viewpoint was to show their self-esteem. You'll be surprised to know there's a high suicide rate in this area, in Kashmir as well as this area. In the other parts of Kashmir, you also find that due to some kind of relationship involvement. Now let's look towards so-called security marriage for these girls who are falling into relationships. And thinking that this emotional relationship is for the girls, they think they need to marry. But for boys, it's a big deal and say they are not ready to marry, the girls go home and bring their sister. And that's how many of these are misused of anti-racism in a different way. But she's looking at to security in this high insecure zone of conflict area. So also is happening in Congo nowadays, where mature women are being raped, both from their own army and need to look at that and think about it. And psychologists believe it is this starts very early in life when the child develops a kind of bonding with the breast, the mother, being the breastfed by the mother. And doesn't know when to call the men to go.